Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Chris. I'm a developer here at Accessoft, and I want to talk today about some of the basics of SSH and how you can use it to authenticate with a remote service. This is all in the context of Git. As most of you know, there are two parts of an SSH key, a public and a private. The public, as the name implies, is public. You can put it anywhere. You want to upload it to a remote server so the server itself knows who is talking and who can use that key to authenticate as the user. The private part is the important part. You want to keep that secret. That should never leave your machine. It's also important that you keep it locked down. If there's any doubt that your machine might be compromised in any way, you want to put a passphrase on the key. So the way this works is an app will send a request with the list of all the public keys that it has access to. And it'll send that to the server. The server will find the public key that it has, that it knows that the user is allowed to use. And you can think of a public key as a lock template, a template for creating a lock that can only be unlocked by the client or by the corresponding private key. The server will generate one of these locks and send a request with the lock to the client. The client, assuming it has this private key, will send the result of unlocking this lock back up to the server, and that tells the server that the client is allowed to perform these actions on the server. So let's go one step deeper, and that's with SSH agents. So the way an agent works is it's a program that runs on the client that kind of deals with all of this so that the app itself doesn't have to know about how this works. So essentially what happens is, instead of having all this information going directly to the app, it's instead going to the agent, and then the agent communicates with the app instead. And the benefits of this are that the agent is the only thing that has to know how to talk to the server. The app itself doesn't have to know what the encryption of the keys is. The app doesn't need to know where the keys are, like each individual app. So you'd add a key once to the agent, and then any app that can communicate with that agent on the client already has access to all those keys, and it doesn't have to, you don't have to add it individually. Kind of the basics of SSH. Hope this video is helpful.